Hi guys, this is Dan Tabar of Atomontage, and I'm going to show you some really cool stuff that just came online today. So I will start a Google search for, dinosaur toy, and go to images, right? Image search, good old image search, and click on any of these guys, right? So our partner CSM, Common Sense Machines, they have an amazing platform that turns these images, still images from anywhere, into 3D models. Pretty amazing. This is their site. It's CSM Cube is the name of the platform. And yeah, let's see what we can do with these dinosaur toys. So I'm going to drag off this tab and drag in the dinosaur. Boom. I set one setting here and this will start turning into a dinosaur. I have some prepared already. I just wanted to show how you get that started. So here's one that came from a toy box of images I had downloaded before. These are G.I. Joes and Mask and all these other cool toys from the 80s that I grew up with. This is just another one of these dinosaur toys. This is actually not from the 80s, but it's a newer one. It doesn't matter. Dragged it in here. We got this 3D mesh in here. And it's got an extra leg. You know, don't worry about it. We're going to fix that. This is what happens when computers imagine what we're the hallucinate a little bit, and it's got some weird texture issues. Maybe like there's an eye up here and there's no eye on this side. So this is the cool thing about the CSM Cube platform, is that you can now do these very powerful retexturing with AI, again powered by generative AI, in a way that's super compelling. So I have the model that I created again from that single image, and CSM just did that for me. And now I can move it until I get this 2D image that, oh, look at that eye. I like that eye there, right? So it generates something based on this prompt on here that you can actually get from the image. It's pretty crazy. And now I will actually just paint this eye into it. The render is still finishing, it says. Sometimes this gets a little stuck. So if I zoom in here, so this on the left is the generated. Okay, let's just go with that eye up there. Oh, this big eye. Wow, that's a really scary one. Okay, here we go. So now what I'm going to be able to do now is actually just paint in from this 2D generative AI image that was based on the 3D one. I can like get a better texture from the 2D selectively painted in here. You see the teeth are, I think the teeth look nicer too. So let's get those too. And I'm just doing this super roughly now, but like maybe this nostril is a little cleaner. Maybe this one too. And let's say we're happy with that, right? And then we just bake that in to the 3D model again. Like, presto, it's done. We have a new eye on this dinosaur over here, which is, that is crazy stuff. This is really, really cool. And it's really nice and clean. This side is a mess. I would spend some more time on this side later. For just demonstration purposes here, we're going to be moving along here. So I can now put myself down here, make myself a little smaller so I'm not in the way. And I should be able to just save this. Yeah, so save this and continue. So now we have a dinosaur with at least one proper eye, and that's nice. Now let's get to actually getting this into a place where you can start using this asset, you know, like really the new integration here is that we have CSM coming over seamlessly to the Atomontage Virtual Matter platform. So you can turn this into virtual matter now. Look at this beautiful eye we have now. Ooh, he's scary. He's got this darkness to this guy. But yeah, this is the new stuff over here. So look, I'm gonna point it out this way, I guess. Add to 3D world, you see that? That's the new stuff here. And before you could export a mesh, of course, to OBJ, and can blow that up in your Blender or Unities and Unreals and whatever, and then build a game for a couple of years and publish that. That'd be, you know, one path, of course. But now you can get this within seconds into a 3D world that is in a browser. You can share immediately with anyone by just copying, pasting this URL that you'll have in the browser tab here. So a new tab opened. Now we're transitioning over to the virtual matter realm, and as you can see, immediately as I pop in here, there is a spinning cube again to kind of make this visual link between our two worlds. It is voxelizing a mesh. You have some on-screen help up here above me, above my head. It tells you that there's an F2 toggle to get into the editor. So now currently I'm clearly in some kind of FPS mode. I can shoot this virtual matter in the ground, make holes anywhere. This is a half kilometer large piece of desert. That was a scan, and it's a raw scan, so it looks a little funky, has some floaty stuff and so on. But here we go. Look at this. Voxelizing mesh. Boom. Our dinosaur is coming in here. Isn't that beautiful? It does have three legs, three hind legs, so we can fix that, and I'll show you that in a second. But yeah, we've turned an image, just to recap, like an image, random image off the internet, into a 3D mesh, polygon mesh with textures. We retextured it with CSM super powerful tools on that are AI driven, and now we've turned it into this little tiny dinosaur. So we can go into edit mode. You can see ourselves. We're like a funky little guy here. I want to just turn off the physics, actually. So you go into this hierarchy server. We're actually going to have completely new physics, so this is going to not be an issue. I'm just going to turn it off so I can move it around as I wish. And I will also set the scale and rotation a little bit like that, and then scale him up. So with this purple ball, we can get him a little bigger. Let's see if we can remove that middle leg. It looks a little awkward coming out of his belly there. So again, with these tools, super simple to do. Let me get you some more space here. There you go. And then remove. Where are we? Boom. So remove tool. Now we're carving our virtual matter away. So virtual matter is essentially streamed microvoxels, is the technical term. Voxels you may have heard of before. It's all cubes. So there's stuff on the inside of this guy. As you can see, when I'm carving away this leg, there's not a hollow thing like with polygons. It's actually voxels all the way through. So we can now filter. Let me move this. And we can smooth this belly. Maybe make him a little bit inflated here so he doesn't look like he's too emaciated. So there's these tools to push and pull. We are reworking this whole UI, so it's not going to be so clunky looking, but for now the tools are here and they are working. So yeah, now we're smoothing out. He's got a little bit of a pot belly there. That's nice. So now, that was a few seconds of work that eliminated that leg. That would have been a lot more work with polygons, let me tell you. It is, you would end up with a big hole. You would have to like cap that hole somehow and worry about all the textures and everything. Also, I want to note that the resolution of this guy will be higher. We're bumping up that resolution on the voxelization, as we call it, when we turn it from the mesh to the virtual matter here. But for now, let's just get this guy going in the game mode. So I can look at this guy from any angle, of course. He is that 3D object here, and I should be able to pick him up. Yep, I pick him up in the game mode, and I can actually stamp him, make a little herd of these guys, right? So these guys are roaming the lands here. I can also actually remove, if I use the other, you see I'm actually creating footprints in the ground with his feet. So we got dinosaur footprints here. Aren't they pretty? That's going to come in later when we have physics going. The physics are literally coming in the next week here. So we're going to have a proper physics solver. And when these objects fall on the ground, it's going to be pretty wild to see how they actually affect the ground and cause damage to things, let's just say. So yeah, this is our dinosaur we've created from a picture, turned into mesh, fixed that mesh in with the textures. We see that beautiful eye we got there, very, very like, kind of menacing looking. And we've used this guy to make a little dinosaur herd here. That's this video. I wanna show you some other stuff later. Well, let's see. Can we find some other things here? Like we've working on this. I think I have another couple of. Let's see. I wanted to get some turtle shells in here. So yeah, there's some steps in the CSM workflow here that turns this into a preview first quickly and then a final mesh. I will do another video where I show you how to actually modify your own avatar. You see the avatar is very, very plain Jane. This is the one that we're running around as when we hit F2, but we can give him some cool accoutrements, let's say, and make him a lot more interesting with these CSM generated models that are turned into virtual matter. So that's for another video. Here is a little dinosaur herd that I created in, what was it? Literally 10 minutes. All right, guys, so from scratch. So thanks a lot, have a good one, and we'll see you in the next video. Cheers, bye. I'm back. I just wanted to show, like, the whole point of virtual matter, of course, is that you can do interesting things with it, right? These dinosaurs, they're all malleable. Like, I can blast these guys. I just want to make sure that is clear. I can shoot the heck out of these guys, and that is the point. So these will be much more interesting fleshy wounds based on the materials, which will be fleshy, and there will be bones inside. And so on, like when you actually, if you want to build them up that way, you would have some bones and you would like a skeleton, a dinosaur skeleton and flesh and bones inside, and you can just kind of merge that into the depth of these dinos. So again, this is just to demonstrate that everything has depth, and you see these voxels on the inside, which will be higher resolution too, by the way, when the resolution is upped on these models. So that's all I wanted to point out. Again, there's a lot more work to be done. The physics and the materials and so on are all coming in now. And there's gonna be even more stuff like cast shadows and other cool stuff, but just stay tuned for that and have a good one. Bye. Boom.